Look what Obama's $500 million library is missing. Americans are calling it criminal. Will the shadow of the Obama administration ever leave us? Not anytime soon, as Barry is trying to cement his mark on the country with a massive $500 million library dedicated to his legacy. Most former presidents get a library. They are meant to commemorate their time in office, but mostly it's about giving back to their community with resources that value education and knowledge. It's less about the man and more about honoring the country. But this is Obama we're talking about, so it's all about the man. That's why it's costing $500 million to build the reportedly ugly thing. And that's why the most important aspect of the library will be oddly unavailable. Image result for Obama Library from Daily Caller. The $500 million Obama Center, a soul-crushing, concrete architectural monstrosity, will feature basketball courts, a recording studio, meeting rooms, an auditorium, a children's play garden and, of course, an exhibition hall for Odes to the World Historical Idea of Barack Obama. Unlike every other presidential library, however, it will be bereft of historical documents. Presidential historian Gilroy suggested that the libraryless library is terrible for people seeking to understand the past. There's always one particular person, a chief of staff, a liaison, that those collections really illuminate, Troy told the Tribune. When you view the collection, you meet the people around the president, not just the president. That comes from being there, not just logging on. All archivists are waiting to see how this will work because we are all struggling with how to make things available digitally, Glowatsky told the Tribune. I think, in this case, it's such a massive amount of material that it will be important to see how they are able to deliver it and make it easy to search. Keeping the records digital also means they are easier to alter. You know, real paper records can't be changed so easily. Ink is pretty much permanent. Plus, having a physical archive means having a liaison that can aid visitors who want to look up records. We can't have that. We don't want people digging through Obama's records. They might find something that will make him look bad. The Obama administration, despite what he claimed, was the least transparent in history. He allowed the NSA to spy on Americans, neglected an ambassador to die overseas, and used the IRS to punish political rivals. Imagine the other things he was up to that we don't know about. Keeping the records online will make it harder for people to dig through. It means they can alter, delete, or hide files they don't want people to see. That's harder to do with physical documents. This is yet another shadowy move by a president whose motives were always suspect from the beginning.